Johann Friedrich Krummnow. Johann Friedrich Krummnow, or Krumnow 1811, 3 October 1880, was a German-born settler in Australia. He arrived in South Australia in 1839, and in 1852 he founded a community named Herrnhut located near Penshurst in Western Victoria. This was Australia's first intentional community based on the principles of shared property and fervent prayer. Krumnow died at Herrnhut in October 1880. Arrival in Australia. Johann Friedrich Krumnow was born in 1811 in Posen, Kingdom of Prussia, later known as Poznan, Poland, and was raised in a German community. He worked as a tailor, cobbler and teacher, and was an adherent of a variety of the Moravian Brethren within the Lutheran faith. He arrived in Port Adelaide on 22 January 1839 from Hamburg on the ship Katharina with a group of dissidents, Cable's people. On board ship he taught girls, but was deemed not completely satisfactory, and the community did not allow him to teach in Australia. Although thwarted in his ambition to be ordained as a Lutheran pastor, Krumnow held regular prayer meetings in private homes. By 1842, he was a naturalized English citizen and was legally able to purchase land. At Lothal, German settlers provided Krumnow with the funds for land purchases to establish a community. Krumnow wanted it based on his own principles of shared property and fervent prayer. The Lothal settlers rejected Krumnow's vision and legally disputed his right to the land titles. After 1847, he spent 3 years as a missionary, living and working with indigenous Australian communities around Mount Gambier. Krumnow is described by Theodore Hebbart in 1881. Another disturbing factor of these early days was the activity of the separatist and visionary, Johann Friedrich Krumnow. He was a queer fellow, deformed and gnome-like in appearance, with a positive genius for bobbing up in the places where he was least wanted, sowing the seeds of trouble and mischief wherever he went. Clandestine prayer meetings in Lights Pass, exercising of evil spirits, land dealing at Lopeful, these were but some of the side issues of his main scheme, the realization of a communistic settlement. A similar description appeared in the Hamilton Spectator in November 1880. He was a little deformed man. Gnomed man. Gnomed man. Gnomed man. Gnomed man. Gnomed man. Gnomed man. Warmed man, warmed man, man, warmed man, warmed man, formed man, warmed man, warmed man, warmed man. His face was dark and wrinkled, his hair black, long, and unkempt. In public he always wore an overcoat of black cloth and latterly of a possum skin, which with a broad-crowned German military cheese-cutter cap completed a costume which, as I have said, was characteristic of the man. Fearing possible excommunication from the Lutheran Church for his unorthodox religious views, Krumnow left South Australia. Founding of Herrnhut. By 1851, Krumnow had moved to the Melbourne suburb of Collingwood, where he worked as a tailor, cobbler, and preacher. He then moved to Germantown, later called Grovedale, near Geelong, which had been established by Lutherans in 1849. In 1852, a group of German migrants, led by Krumnow, pooled their resources and purchased 1584 acres, 6.41 km2 of land near Mount Rouse in western Victoria, about 3 miles, 4.8 km northwest from Penshurst. As the leader and a naturalized British subject, the title deeds were in Krumnow's name. The settlers erected a number of stone dwellings, including a church described by the Belfast Gazette in 1857, reprinted in the Argus as a very substantial stone church. It is 60 feet long by 27 feet in width. The settlement was named Herrnhut after a Moravian Brethren refuge in Saxony and numbered less than 40 individuals. The Belfast Gazette further praised the people, proverbially sober and industrious, are prospering as they deserve to do. The farm predominantly ran sheep, but also had a small number of cattle and horses. Krumnow became an accomplished shearer, giving demonstrations to local farmers. Soon, however, the harmony of the group was interrupted by a dispute about the ownership of the Herrnhut land. Krumnow had made the title of sale in his name alone, despite having used funds from the community to purchase the land. His refusal to change this prompted several members to leave the community and leave with nothing. Other Lutherans in the district were discontent with Krumnow after his group had purchased some 200 Queensland cattle. A number of these Lutherans with whips and dogs drove the cattle at a gallop to the station. The cattle were nearly fat, with the result that the whole mob died before morning. The resulting loss was £2,000, a severe blow from which the Moravian. Krumnow is part of the area's local folklore, and it is often difficult to separate the legend from the man. It is said that his treatment of children was overly strict and often violent. Krumnow believed that medicine was unnecessary and all internal ailments could be cured by prayer alone. In May 1864, at the inquest into the death of one of his followers, George Carger, Krumnow described the group's beliefs. "I am a Moravian minister. Deceased was a member of the society here. When he was taken ill, we did not send for a doctor, as our religious principles do not authorize the calling in of medical aid for any internal complaints. We would do so for a broken limb or an external wound. If we had sent for a doctor in the present case, we would have been breaking the laws of our church and the rules of the society." "I do not believe that a doctor or medicine can prolong life. It cannot be proved. Herrnhut opened its doors to impoverished and destitute peoples, as well as providing shelter, food, and money for indigenous Australians' communities in times of crisis. At one stage, Herrnhut gave sanctuary to over 300 Aborigines who hunted kangaroos on the property and left many middens at their camping ground." Maria Heller. One of the most significant events in Herrnhut's history is the arrival of Maria Heller, a self-styled prophetess who had set up a similar community at Hills Plain near Benalla, Victoria, in early 1875. The Hills Plain commune failed in its first year, 8 of its members, among them children, dying of famine and other related ailments. Krumnow offered to bring Heller's people to Herrnhut, which he did late that year in 2 convoys of wagons. In March 1876, the South Australian Register reported that Krumnow had agreed to pay all their debts and to regulate their affairs under the condition of their joining his community and of entering into the bosom of his church. Some accounts recall Heller as a wild woman possessed of an uneven temper, whose followers brought discontent to the austere Herrnhut community. In August 1876, police arrested Heller as a dangerous lunatic, suffering from religious mania upon complaint by one of the Herrnhut residents. One unsubstantiated source tells of how the Hills Plain people introduced musical instruments and dance into the community. In a short time, a rift was apparent between the old and new settlers, and by late that year, Heller and her followers left. Heller settled 23 kilometers, 14 miles away in Hochkirk, now Tarrington, and married a fellow Hills Plain and Herrnhut resident, Ernst Skoltz. Krumnow is said to have never fully recovered from Heller's rejection of his beliefs and spent his remaining days under the influence of alcohol. Johann Friedrich Krumnow died intestate on 3 October 1880, leaving £5,826, 1811. After his death, the local folklore records that he was buried face down so as to prevent his soul from rising to heaven. This unsubstantiated claim is almost certainly false. Krumnow's eulogy was delivered by August Hildebrandt, the settlement's baker, and a long-term adherent attendees at the funeral were his friends and followers. In April 1885, the Argus correspondent, the vagabondess James, described Herrnhut and its founder according to the observations of local farmers, John and Thomas Hutton. Krumnow was a German Slav by birth, shoemaker by profession, socialist by opinion, and he ruled the community by fear and not by love, although he exercised the right. According to Charles Mayer in the Victorian Historical Journal 1978, from available evidence there is no need to accept the rather biased description by Vagabond S. James that the women and young girls toiled in the fields early and late, some clothed only in an old sack toiled as hard as any Negro slave. Vagabond's view is also disputed by William Metcalf and Betty Huff in their 2002 book, Herrnhut, Australia's First Utopian Commune. Herrnhut's strong, charismatic leader, Johann Krumnow, and the peculiar ways of the communards led to their vilification by the press as a wicked cult, full of sexual deviance and other misdemeanors. Sick. In truth, the Herrnhut community struggled on after Krumnow's death for some years until, with 8 members left, it dissipated in 1889. Partial ruins of the church and other buildings still remain. Media. A book about Krumnow and the Herrnhut community was written in 2002, Herrnhut, Australia's First Utopian Commune, by William Metcalf and Betty Huff. It is currently out of print. On 26 February 2003, Australian Broadcasting Corporation's Radio National transmitted Herrnhut on ARC Stories with the presenter, Rachel Cohn, interviewing Metcalf about the settlement, Krumnow, and some of the mistakes early settlers made in rural areas.